Can a second generation i5 CPU from 2011 still be good in 2022? Can that thing even run Windows 11? Will it be slow? Or can it keep up with the demands of today's apps? Is it still relevant? Is this processor even worth considering? In this video, we're going to perform some tests and find out. Let's jump in. So I've got Windows 11 installed now, and for the most part, I mean, it seems pretty smooth. Let's open up Microsoft Word to start. Pretty fast. I don't see any hesitation, any lag. Let's open up Excel. Open up a workbook. You can even see down here, as soon as the cursor hovers over the Excel symbol, the thumbnail preview loads up, which is great to see. Let's try PowerPoint. It's fast. I mean, I don't see any lag, any hesitation. Let's go for the Microsoft Store. A little bit of loading to get the Microsoft Store open, but I mean, once we're in, it seems pretty zippy. Running Windows 11 Pro, and we've got 10 gigs of RAM installed. I cached 512 in the BIOS for the video card. Our network speed. We're getting 866.5 megabits per second on the Wi-Fi card, so we're connected via Wi-Fi. Let's do a test on Google Chrome. Open up some pages, some searches. Let's go cooking. Fast. Let's go food. Very fast. Let's go technology. I mean, for a second gen i5, this thing is really fast. Let's head on over to YouTube. Let's pop open my channel. Advertisement plays pretty quick. Let's see if we can get out of this ad. Let's go over to this one. Video loads up pretty fast. We're at 720. Let's head over to 1080. This is the integrated graphics card for this Asus motherboard that this second gen i5 2300 is installed on. I mean, it's loaded quite a bit of the video pretty quick. Let's click over here to an unloaded section. I mean, it just jumps over there pretty fast. I mean, not only is Windows 11 fast on this second gen i5, it's very stable. Let's go full screen. This is a great way to test the graphics card, whether integrated or PCIe. Minimize, maximize while streaming and look for lag. Yeah. Seems pretty strong, to be honest. Now, for all you techies out there, the solid-state hard drive that this second-gen i5 is running on is the Kingston SV300. Now, for this SSD to have 33,605 hours use on it and still be reading 96% health status, they really don't make SSDs like this anymore. And at the time when this SSD was made, it was considered a budget SSD. So, take that in. As for the read and write speed, I'm getting 479 megabits per second read with 196 megabits per second write. So, I feel like these read write speeds on this Kingston SV300 is what's contributing to the great performance we're experiencing on this second gen i5 on Windows 11. .04 seconds from power button to ready desktop. For a CPU from 2011, this is not that bad. So can this second generation i5 CPU from 2011 still be good in 2022? I think this video definitely proved it can. It's fast on Microsoft Office, Google Chrome, internet browsing, stable on Windows 11. For the everyday average user, this is definitely an incredible budget CPU to consider if you're in the market for one that can keep up with the majority of performance requirements in 2022. Hope you guys found value. Hit that like and subscribe button, and don't be shy, leave a comment in the comment section. Till the next one, stay safe out there, guys.